Spellbinder's brand new Build-A-Wreath set. That is what we're focusing on today. I'm Tina McDonald, and today I'm going to show you how to create this beautiful little mini book using some of my favorite dies from Spellbinders, also going to be using a bezel from the Medium Exhaust collection, and adding some beautiful detail to the front of this very vintage looking mini book. To begin, we need two pieces of patterned paper, a graph piece of craft paper, and a striped piece. We're going to go ahead and distress our edges. To do so, I just ran my fingernail along the edge of the paper to rough it up a little bit. This softens it and gives it a bit of an aged look. Then we're also going to add some distress ink to give it some color. So go ahead and rough up all those edges, and then we'll be able to move on to our next step. Now that we have everything nicely distressed, we're going to go ahead and adhere the striped paper to the graph paper. We're going to center these, and then we're going to raise the edges just a little bit more to make them look nicely distressed. Once we have achieved the distressed look that we want, before we add it to the front of our mini book, we're going to run it through the sewing machine without thread. Doing so will add holes that will add to the beautiful distressed look of our mini book. Now it's time to do some die cutting. We're going to lightly tape in place using a low tack tape, labels 25, die number 5 onto black cardstock. We're also going to lightly tape the majestic labels 25, die number 4 onto a craft graph paper. We're going to place these on the A base plate with the die facing down and the paper showing. Then we're going to cover them with the white plate, which is the cutting plate. And then we're going to run these through the grand caliber machine. This is going to cut them. Then we're also going to use the tan embossing mat and the pink embossing plate, and we're going to emboss our pieces as well. Once these are cut and embossed, you're going to remove the negative piece. You're going to remove the black cardstock from the labels 25, but please keep the majestic labels 25 piece in the die template. We're going to do a little bit of stenciling. We're going to take a little bit of distress ink and a sponge, and we're just going to lightly add some color to just the edges inside of the die template. This is going to add to the age, vintage, distressed look of our piece. Once you've finished, you can remove the template from the paper. This, you'll be able to see the beautiful detailing that this has given us. Now we're going to adhere the majestic labels 25 to the center of the labels 25, which is the black cardstock. Now go ahead and adhere that to the front of the paper that we prepared at the beginning of this video. For this project, I've been using Xyron's Mega Runner. I find it's a fabulous adhesive and it's so easy to use. So we'll adhere that right to the front. Make sure it's nice and straight and press it down. Next, we're going to take this and we're actually going to go ahead and adhere this to the front of the actual mini book. Now we're going to create the beautiful focal point of our album, which is this beautiful wreath filled with glitter created from Spellbinder's new Build-A-Wreath set. We're going to begin with our junior magnetic placement mat. What this does is it's going to hold our dies in place. So we're going to place this with the magnet side up on top of our base plate. Then we're going to take the dies and we're going to place them all on top of this placement mat fairly close together because we want to get the most out of our cardstock that we can. So go ahead and place them all on wherever they will fit, nice and cozy together. Then we're going to place our cardstock, which is, I'm using the Coordinations Craft Core, and this is in a beautiful deep green. So we're going to place this over top, then we're going to add our cutting plate, which is the white plate, and then we're going to run these through our grand caliber machine. We're also going to then emboss them using the tan embossing mat and the pink embossing plate. Once we have done this, we're going to repeat the process 5 times, cutting each of the smaller pieces numerous times to make the fullness of the wreath. We don't need to cut the base of the wreath again, as we only need one of those, but we will cut each of the other pieces in multiples. Once we have everything cut, we're going to take a sanding block and we're going to sand the embossed areas on each of these pieces to expose the craft core, which is underneath. Now it's time to begin to assemble our wreath. You'll notice on the base of the wreath there are little slots cut from the die template. This is where we're going to be inserting our pieces for the dimension of our wreath. Once you've found the shape that you would like for your wreath with just the larger pieces, go ahead and adhere those down with a hot glue gun. I just did so by lifting the pieces and that way I can still shape them exactly where I want them, and yet they're adhered down really well. Then we're going to go ahead and add all of our smaller pieces to fill in the detailing. You can reshape this as you go, but once the hot glue is dry, as you know, they're not going to budge. Now it's time to add some glitter. I began with Sparkle and Sprinkles brushable glue, and I used a paintbrush, and I went ahead and brushed some of this glue right on the ends of our wreath pieces. All of these beautiful pieces of fern are now covered with a beautiful thick layer of this brushable glue. Then we're going to go ahead and apply our glitter and shake it off and let it dry. Now we can go ahead and adhere our wreath to the front of our album. I also went ahead and made a beautiful little bow from a gingham ribbon and added a button with twine tied in the center. We'll go ahead and adhere all of that to the front of our album now. And for the final touch, I added a bezel from our Media Mixage collection. I used Ovals 1 bezels and dies, and then I added the year inside of there. So we'll go ahead and adhere that onto the front of our mini book, and then our project is complete. And that completes our project for today. And that's only the cover. Imagine the fun you can have decorating the inside of this adorable vintage mini book. Thanks for tuning in.